simplify it like we would any fraction, do they have any factors in common?
40, oh wait, no.
Doesn't take too long to figure out.
Seven.
We can't simplify it, because this is 7 times 7.
Yeah, so
but this is, well, no, there's no 7 in that, right?
2 divided by 9, and 9 by that, that'd be 2 and 3.
Tyler, what are you talking about?
Divide by 3.
In order to simplify a fraction, we have to divide the same thing out of both of them, right? Which we can't do. This does not have a 7 in it.
So
divide by
3.
Only 7 in it.
3. Divide by 3.
This doesn't have a factor of 3.
Okay.
It's just 7 times 7, right? And,
right.
You know, after doing this for decades. 49 is 7 times 7. 7 and 7 are both prime numbers. So they're not going to break down and have a 3 in them, right? So.
Unless they have a.
And we can also use a little trick of add the digits together. 9 plus 4 is 13. And 13 is not divisible by 3, so I know it's not going to have a factor of 3. You guys know that trick?
No.
Well, I just told you, add the digits together,
yeah,
and
if
the digits is divisible by 3,
right.
And the number is divisible by 3.
I know that trick.
Yeah,
so
it's
8 plus 1
check,
equals 9.
No, Valet taught us that.
Yeah, I remember that.
Yeah, it's just
so
7, and then there's 7 over 2.
So we can't simplify that fraction. 18 and 49 don't have any common factors. We cannot divide 18 and 49 by the same thing.
Ouch.
Can't simplify it any further. So we abandon that idea. We're not going to be able to simplify it that way. So we use that property that we learned, and we have the square root of 18 over the square root of 49. We can take the numerator under its own square root and the denominator in its own square root.
I'm not talking about that. I'm just talking about this.
This? What are you going to tell me about this?
38, all you have to do is just put 7.
Just put 7.
No. 7, right? 7 right there. Put a line above the 7. That's a dividing line.
Okay.
Or whatever. Alright. Yeah. There we go. And then you can just do, I can't remember if it's 2 to the square root of 3 or the square root of 3 to the square root of 2.
It's neither of those.
Yeah, it is.
Well, not yet. Because we don't need to remember what it is.
Do you have your calculator? Me? I'm feeling my brain myself. I know what I'm doing.
It's the square root of something times the square root of something, right, Emily? It is 9 times 2. It's also 6 times 3, but that wouldn't be helpful. Let's look at why that wouldn't be helpful. Why is square root of 6? Neither of those what?
Have square roots.
Oh, have solid
square
roots. Smooth.
This guy with all the names he has. Smooth square roots. Yeah, no smooth square roots. But 9 has a nice smooth square root.
Right.
It's 3. Mm-hmm. 3 root 2 over 7. If 3 and 7 had a common factor, we would simplify it, but that's going to be impossible since these didn't have any common anyway, so something like that happened.
Oh, question.
Question.
So,
back.
Say if the 3 and 2 and the 7 did equal a smooth number for square root, would you just add all those together and then find the square root?
Not sure.
So, like, say if you added 7 plus 3, which equaled 10.
Why would I add 7 and 3? We're dividing here.
Okay, yeah, never mind.
Okay. So, there it is, fully simplified as much as possible. Square root of 9 is 3. That's, some of you seem to be confused at times, like, well, why is there this 3 here that doesn't have a square root anymore?
Hey, because it's the square root of 9.
Because it's the square root of 9. What's the square root of 9? It's just the number 3, and that's why that just looks like a number and not under a square root, because
you simplified
it. Is. Clint?
So, like, if you were to simplify it, you'd be like 2 times 3, and then 9 times 2 is 18, 7 times 7, and that's how you do it.
Run that by me again real quick?
Well, like, if
map.
You were, map in line.
Is that right? Good job.
Well, like, if you were to, like, do the opposite, you just, like...
Like, go from here to there?
Yeah, 3 times 3, and then, like, times 2. And then
if I tried to write them all under the same square root, well, first of all, to put the two square roots in the numerator together, I'd have to write it as what?
Well, I'm just saying, like, if you were to do the stuff reverse to, like, make it complicated.
Right, so to reverse it, I would have to, in order to multiply these together, this would have to be a square root.
Okay.
So I turn 3 into the square root of 9, is. It's the square root of 9. Now the square root of 9 times the square root of 2 becomes square root of 18. Then I have to write 7 as a square root. It's the square root of 49. And then, yeah, then we wanted to re-complicate it and simplify it. 14 and 15. 14 will fit right there, I'll bet. Okay, square root of 25 over 36.
Ah, that's so easy.
Good shot.
Okay, Kyler, go ahead and tell me what's easy.
I can do just 5 divided by 25, that's 5.
Okay. 5 divided by 25 is 1/5.
Square root of 25 is 5.
Okay.
And the square root of 36 is 6.
This is all the work I'm wanting to see. It's just the square root of 25 over the square root of 36, just like you're saying, square root of 25 is 5. And the square root of 36 is 6.
Alright, so
right? There's all the work that I want to see. One step in between those two. At least for now. In the future, maybe a few weeks from now. If you write the square root of 25 over 36 is 5 sixths, that is not too difficult to see because here's a fraction. We're trying to find the square root of that fraction. Means there must be some fraction that multiplies by itself to give you 25 over 36. Makes sense that it'd be 5 sixths. Because 5 sixths times 5 sixths is 25 over 36. Okay. So that, I mean, there is a level of common sense there. And I wouldn't want you to not see, but I also want to see this step right here.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Are you sure?
We're all helping each other by distracting each other.
I'm
trying to
help them out because they bother.
Number 15.
I helped them out with math.
We're given this expression, square root of x squared plus y times z.
Y times
z. We're told that x is negative 2. Y is 8, z is 1/2. So we just plug those numbers in, correct? Y and z. This looks like the square root of
2.
Negative 2 squared plus 8 times 1/2.
So good, everybody, 16.
Okay, so I'm going to say put parentheses around there because it says to square x. Whatever x is, multiply it by itself. What is x? It is exactly negative 2. So in the place of x, I want to put negative 2. I want exactly whatever's supposed to happen to x to happen to negative 2. So what's negative 2 squared? Do you think it's 4 or it's negative 4?
4.
Positive 4.
There you go. It's positive 4 because it's negative 2 times negative 2, which is 4. So we get the square root of 4.
Ah, 4.
Plus 8 times a half.
16.
4.
8 times a half is 4. Good one. 4 plus 4 is 8, so you got the square root of 8.
Divide that by.
No,
divide
by 8. Times 2.
4 times
square root
of
4 times square root of 2.
Square root of 4 is 2.
Square root of 4 is 2.
So 2 to square root of 2, that's square root of 2.
Thanks for being very helpful. Okay, so that's 13, 14, 15. Or, no, that was 13. Yeah, it was 13, 14. 3 decent examples. Any questions?
Yeah.
Remember, all the work that I want to see is just like 14. I want to see that you understand that the square root of a fraction is the same as the square root of the numerator or the square root of the denominator. If it's time to use that. But if you have a fraction inside of a square root, make sure that before you do anything, make sure you simplify that fraction as much as possible. Alright. You ready? Let's take out a piece of paper. Those of you not ready, let's take out a piece of paper. Alright, so this one, the square root of 27, not smooth. Square root of 3 also, not smooth. So we don't really have any way to move forward unless we use the property we just learned where the square root of 27 over the square root of 3 is the square root of what?
9.
27 over 3, which is 9.
Oops.
And square root of 9.
I thought we could do
that. The ones we can't do are like the square root of something plus the square root of something else and add them together, square root of something minus square root of something else, and subtract with the square root. But we've established for multiplication and division.
How come you just can't do 3 to the square root of 3 divided by 3?
Alright. It's not divided by 3.
Square root of 3.
We can do that, then we can do square root of 9. Times square root of 3 over square root of 3. Square root of 9 is 3. Square root of 3 over the square root of 3. And the square root of square root of 3 divided by the square root of 3.
Oh,
darn
it.
So now
it's
like the 3, you
know?
I got it.
I got it.
It's just
I
didn't
simplify it.
Well, just like,
I didn't simplify it one more.
I stopped at 27 over 3.
Will you please stop talking? Thank you.
So, just like, if this were 3 times 2 over 2, well, that would be 6 over 2. Then those factors would always just cancel each other out. Root 3 divided by root 3. Even though we don't know what they are, we know if we divide a number by itself, we get 1.
So, if you didn't simplify
all
the way to
3,
did you get it wrong?
Yeah, you'd get like a 3 out of 5. Because you know that you can't simplify.
Oh, okay.
Alright, square root of 4/9. This is a lot like number 14, I think it was. It is 2/3. And the only thing I want to see, at least, at the very least, is square root of 4 over square root of 9. 2/3. Okay? That's all it is. At least for the time being, as we're trying to display our knowledge of this property. Answer the square root of 4/9 in my calculator. Yeah, 2/3? Sure. That's not what I'm asking you to do.
Yes.
I'm asking you to learn this small thing here. Not a lot.
It's kind of a lot.
I'm asking you to do the impossible. All right. Now we're going to kind of make the expression a little more complex.
Oh, that's
simplify it. I'm just going to work this one out from beginning to end, and hopefully we'll elicit some questions. Okay?
We're going to note that.
Some notes, of course.
I don't have an idea.
That makes up 6 plus.
So,
square root. Alright, well, like I said, I'm going to work this out just without any explanation. Okay, I'm sure you'll be able to follow it, but then we'll work on our questions from there. Okay, so I'm going to simplify the square root first. So it's 6 plus square root of 4 times the square root of 2. For 2. Then I'll take the square root of 4, which is 2, so we have 2 root 2. 2. Then I'm going to factor out that 2 and get 3 plus root 2. 2. I'll write this as 2 over 2 times 3 plus root 2. Over 1. 2 divided by 2 is 1, and so we're just left with 3 plus root 2.
Bless you. Thank you.
So we have 1 divided by 1 times 3 plus root 2 over 1. Why is it
over
2? Root 2? What's that?
And then over 2.
Why is it over 2?
Never mind. Yeah.
Why can't you just not say 1? Because it equals 2 over 2.
Yep.
Could go to so does it equal 1? Because it looked like we had to do more things.
This is 1.
Uh huh.
So what we have here is root, so let's look at this right side first. 3 plus root 2 over 1. If I divide by 1, that doesn't really change anything, right? Like
right.
If I don't write 5 over 1, I always just write 5.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So we can forget about writing the over 1. It's really unnecessary. So what we have now is 3 plus root 2. Then I'm going to multiply that by 1, which again, doesn't change it at all when you multiply by 1. So just 3 plus root 2. Does that make sense?
Yeah, because you can't do anything with the 1.
Yeah, well, the 1 doesn't do anything at all. Mom.
How did you get the 2 times 3 plus root 2 over?
Because you took 6 and you took it in half to get it to 2 root 3.
Right.
You split.
Kyler, can you stop writing? Stop writing on her notes!
Hurry, I'm showing her.
Here's how you can be sure that this and that are the same. Okay, I'm just going to distribute the 2. Okay, 2 times the 3 is 6.
Oh.
2 times root 2 is 2 times root 2. Okay, so when we go this way, we call that factoring. And I'm sure what Kyler was saying is correct. So we're taking the 2 from the 6, we're taking the 2 from the 2 root 2 outside, right? We're factoring it out, undistributing it. Mm-hmm. Okay.
So then right there, the 2 over 2 times 3 plus square root of 2 over 1. Is that just the same? That's the same thing as the other problem on the left, right?
Yeah, it's got to be, because if it was any different, then I would, you know, I couldn't put the equals there,
okay.
And this answer would be kind of useless. And so What I'm saying here is we have 2 times 3 plus root 2. What I want to show you is that this 2 and this 2 can simplify each other. This 2 can divide that 2. Okay. To prove that to you, I'm just writing it as 2 fractions multiplied together. So you can clearly see that 2 and 2 can interact with each other without like affecting this stuff over here. Okay. So this 2 can divide that 2. You don't have to worry about it. The thing that we're going to be tempted to do, even as I tell you right now not to do this, you're going to be tempted to just take, at the very beginning, to take this 6 and this 2, turn this into a 3, and turn this into a 1. Okay. A lot of people do that. I call it violating weeping kitten theorem. And when you simplify that way, when you just take this 6 and divide by the 2, okay, every time you do that, this poor little kid right here sheds a tear.
I don't think it's cats. Paper.
If you hate cats, you can just keep doing that, but you'll also get poor scores on your tests. Yes?
Wait, can't you just go and take 6 and just like, can't be just like 4 and 3 then, if you divide it by 2?
Oh, no.
What?
Oh. No, we can't. You want to take the 2 and divide it into the 8 and to the 6, right?
Yeah.
But the 8, it's not really 8.
Oh, so
it's inside a square root.
Okay, so you just go and like go 4 and 2.
So to do what you're suggesting, we first have to figure out that this 2 can, like there's a factor of 2 in there.
Yeah.
This is 2 times square root of 2. And from there, you can do what you're saying. You can divide this by 2 and divide this by 2, and you get 3 plus 1 times the square root of 2, which, if you remember, that's what we got.
But how could you divide it by 2 if you still have a sign there?
If we still have a what?
Oh, wait, you just keep the sign there. Okay.
The difference being that I divided both of these by a 2, not just the 6.
No, but like, how do you divide the sign there on the 2?
This sign?
No.
This sign, the square root?
Yeah.
Because what I'm saying is that there's 2 times the square root of 2, half of that, half of 2 times square root of 2 would just be 1 square root of 2.
So can you just be like, not divide the 2, just divide the other 2?
This 2?
No, the other
2. This 2?
Yeah, just have 1 because you're
that's what it is, yeah. That's exactly what this is, right? There's a 1 times the square root of 2 down here.
Okay.
I divide the 6 by 2, I get 3. Divide the 2 by a 2, this 2 by a 2, I get a 1.
But
so right there,
the other 2.
I
wouldn't divide this by a 2 because it's inside a square root, this other 2 is not.
Okay, that makes sense.
So, Mr. Stewart, right there, you could just pretty much go, can you move your pen onto the one I'm talking about?
Onto
that one?
This
right there, couldn't you just pretty much divide that one already?
As long as you divide this one by 2 and this one by 2, and if there is another term, or divide that one by 2.
But, so right there, you can just
you could do divide by 2, divide by 2, divide by 2, however many terms there are separated by addition and subtraction. And to show you that we can, I kind of did that here. So I essentially did that there. I divided this by 2 and divided this by 2. I put the 2 out here. Just to show you that the 2 is canceling the 2 from both of these terms, because both of these terms had a 2. To show you that, I brought the 2 out here. Do we have to do all of these steps every time? No.
No.
No, we don't. I mean, even starting back here, we can see that that 2 could divide that 2 without doing all of this, so we can go straight from here to there. And then again, we can do like Tyler was talking about, can I just divide that by 2 and that by 2? Yeah, we can back up to that far and just jump right to the answer. The thing we want to avoid, though, is dividing like just the 6 by a 2. Right? We don't want that to happen. Kyle?
So is it supposed to be 3 plus the square root of 2? Or would you multiply the 3 times square root of 2?
Well, like the final answer?
Uh-huh.
Well, that is 3 plus the square root of 2. It comes from back here. When I factored a 2 from here and from here,
mm-hmm.
right, it's 3 plus. Because I distributed the 2, I would get 2 times 3 is 6, and 2 times, it's distribution, right? To get it back to this way.
Yeah.
So that's that. 2 times square root of 2 is 2 root 2. So it's not, they're not multiplied, they're added together. But
why do you have to like switch the 3 and the 2 around?
Switch them?
Yeah, because like, well, 6 divided by 2 is 3.
Yes.
Why is there a 2 then?
Here?
Yeah.
So, this is the same as Molly's question. It's there because I took it, I divided it out of the 6 and I divided it out of the 2. brought it outside, like if you imagine parentheses around here, I'm taking that factor outside, I'm doing the opposite of distributing, I'm factoring. If I were to distribute the two, I would see it would come out the same. 2 times 3, 6. 2 times the square root of 2, 2 root of 2.
Okay.
So just factored out the 2. You can be sure that I factored it out correctly if you distribute it and it comes back the same as it started. Now, if I were to, I want us to show a few more steps here for a few examples, but if I were a novice at this, or sorry, a pro at this, I would just say, okay, well, first I've got to write this as 6 plus 2 root 2. Might even do that in my head at some point, square root of 8, 2 root 2 over 2, and then I might say, like, okay, this is a 3, this is a 1, this is a 1, I get 3 plus root 2, like, saw my homework doing this. That's probably about how much I'd have written down. But I wanted to help you understand why we can't just take the 6 and divide it by 2, call it 3 plus the square root of 8. Can't do that. Yeah?
Where does the other 2 go then? Oh, wait, yeah, they cancel.
This one here?
Yeah.
Oh, so did you just split up the 6 into smaller numbers?
Here?
Mm-hmm.
Here I divided the 6 by 2 and I divided the 2 by 2, this 2 here.
Oh, okay, because
it's 6 times 2, 2 times 2.
Is that because the 2 is, okay, yeah, I get it.
So I kind of factored out the 2, as you see down here almost,
mm-hmm.
You can't see it, half of it at least. I did that kind of all at once. Like, I see there's a 2 in the 6, there's a 2 in the 2. There would have to be in order to cancel with this 2.
Right.
Because the entire numerator has to have a 2 times something. All right, let's have you give it a go. See how you
give
do
it. Give it a go about.
Let's say we have the square root of 24. We got a 1 here, 8. Let's try that. So 8 plus square root of 24 over 12. First thing we have to do, we cannot really move forward unless we simplify the square root of 24. Square root of 24 can be simplified as the square root of times the square root of what and what?
4, 6.
As good as it gets, right? From there, we just take the square root of 4, which is 2, 2 root 6, 12.
Oh,
4. Where did you get 2?
I did 3 times 8.
Where did I get 2?
Oh,
four,
right.
Four,
square root.
Two.
Okay, sorry.
I did 3
Kyle?
Times 8, though.
And then you would do 2 times 4 plus the square root of 6.
What did you add? You
plus
2.
Oh.
What's
that?
What
would you then like
this? I like that. I like factoring out the 2 so I can see that the numerator has a factor of 2. Like 2 times... Right, 2 times 4 is 8, plus 2 times something is 2 root 6. Gotta be root 6, right? Plus the square root of 6. All of that is over 12. I could, like I did in the previous example, separate these into two fractions. 2 over 12 times 4 plus root 6 over 1. Can you stop talking? You can see annoyed faces on your peers' faces. Saying, please, stop.
One comment.
Please pay attention.
I'm not even talking to the computer.
Refrain from name calling. Okay. So, at this step, I could just divide the 2 and the 12, both of them by 2. This is the 6. So I get 4 plus root 6 over 6. And even though this is a factor of 2, and this has a factor of 2, and the number 6 has a factor of 2, it's inside the square root. Okay? Insides of square roots and outsides of square roots do not play together very well. Only insides of square roots and insides of square roots. So if I could simplify the square root of 6 any further, then I might be able to move on, but I can't. Square root of 6, it doesn't break down. It's anything useful. Just 2 times 3 and 2 or 3, both of them do not have 2 square roots.
Could we try another? You're just doing the same thing by
adding. You can try another. You can also, you can go back to this step here. Divide this by 2, divide this by 2, divide this by 2, you get 4, you get 1, you get 6, and you can just, you know, rewrite that as plus root 6, it's 6. What?
How did it flip from the 8 plus 2 times square root of 6 to 2 times 4 plus square root of 6?
My best explanation I can think of whenever I get this question is, I'll show you how this is the same as that. All I have to do is distribute this 2. 2 times 4 is 8. Distribute the 2 to the root 6. 2 times square root of 6 is 2 times square root of 6.
Okay.
So I'm just doing the reverse of that to get from here to there.
Oh.
I'm taking that 2 out of both of these and putting it out there.
Okay.
Okay. Then it can be redistributed just to confirm that they're the same, but we want to leave it like that, right? So we can divide the 2 and the 12 by 2 each. Let's do another. Say 15 plus square root 75 all over 20. Can someone simplify that square root of 75?
25.
25 square root of 25 is under square root of 3 over 20. So that's
5.
So it might be starting to get to the point where I can go from square root of 75 to 5 root 3 pretty quickly. Just be careful.
Dude, what happens if you put the 3 in front of the 5? Like, the square root of 3.
That's what you got.
And, I mean, the 3.
Then you do 5 times 3 plus.
Well, the fastest answer, I'll give you a better answer in a minute. The fastest answer is it would be wrong.
Yeah, that's what I did.
Alright. 5 times the square root of 3 and 3 times the square root of 5 are different. I'll show you a little example of why that is in a second. Okay, so at this stage, we could do it a couple different ways. I feel like we're still here where we should say, what do 15 and 5 have in common that I can undistribute
three.
From both?
Five.
Does 5 have a factor of 3?
5.
5 and 15 will have a factor of 5. Yeah. Factor out that 5, what I mean by factor out that 5 is if I were to distribute this 5, I'd wind up with this again. So it's 3.
Plus square root of 3.
Square root of 3. The connection between these two, I would distribute the 5 to the 3, 15. Distribute the 5 to the square root of 3, 5 times the square root of 3. Okay. All right, so let's back it up without all that stuff. Okay, it's all over 20 still. But now I can see the factor of 5 in the numerator. Right? I can divide with the 20, right, the factor of 5 in the 20. Right, so this is divided by the 4, so it'd be 3 plus root 3 over 4.
Wait, how did you get...
I got it.
Oh yeah, you do 20 divided by 5, okay.
It's 4, yeah.
And then that cancels that out, I'm guessing, so that makes it... Yep, I'm still learning.
As we all are.
The only thing I get confused with...
Yes?
Is like which one to put into the square root.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay.
Like
I
switched.
Put the 3. I put the 3.
So
there.
Let's.
I put the 5.
Let's break that out in its own problem.
Where did that 3 come from?
Okay.
Yeah.
Square root of 75. This is a great question, and it's a shame people are talking over it. Alright. So we learned a few days ago that there's this property where I can take the square root of, say, 7 times the square root of 5, and that's the square root of 35. Two square roots can multiply together to get one mega square root. Does that make sense? Okay. Well, we can work it in reverse. Square root of 75 can be split apart into two square roots. Let me show you one way to split it apart that does not help at all. That's the square root of 5 times the square root of 15. Why doesn't that help?
I don't
know. No smooth square root. Square root of 5? Not smooth. Square root of 15? Not smooth. It only helps if one of them is smooth, right? It does not have a decimal part. So let's try again. Let's try a different factorization.
25 and 3.
Okay. So they're still inside square roots, so let's just see where we are. Square root of 25 times the square root of 3, multiplying together, got the square root of 75.
Mm-hmm.
Now which one, there's not a coming out of the square root and a staying in the square root. There's just, what is the square root of 25?
5.
It's 5, so that's
easy.
No longer in a square root. It is the square root of 25 is 5. And square root of 3 is not smooth, so we just leave it
like
inside a square root, because if you see. So when we take the square root of 5, it's not that 5 comes out of the square root, it just is the square root of 5. So So there, does that make more sense?
Yeah.
So now we know why there's one not in a square root, one in a square root. This one is just the square root of 25 is 5. And this is the leftover.
What is there going to be our next test due?
Later on. Okay, so there we have, we broke out the square root of 75 part. Let's take a second and look at. What's the square root of x?
X.
Why?
No, the square root of
why?
X is not x. Okay, something. Something.
Another variable.
Some other thing. It's not x.
Right.
And the point is, we don't know. There's no way to know what the square root of x is. Because
mm-hmm.
it's some number x. If you told me what x is, I could move forward, but I don't know what it is. What about the square root of x squared? You know what that is?
Variable
squared.
Square. Something squared. I suppose it is some number.
Well,
that
wouldn't
is,
you,
that could be squared.
If you did have, say, a number that went in, say, like 3, and then 3 times itself, and then would you still have 9, the square root of 9?
Well, let's look at that. So let's look at the square root of 9,
mm-hmm.
right? Yeah. Is 3. Why is the square root of 9 3?
Because 3 times
3.
Itself.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's exactly the logic we need to apply here. 3 is the square root of 9 because 3 times 3 is 9, okay? Square root of x squared is something.
X times x.
Because that thing times itself is x squared. What thing would multiply by itself to give you x squared?
X times x.
Half of x, but the square root of x squared.
Oh, I know what this is. It's x.
It is just x.
X
notice this
x
is the square root of 3 squared. It's just 3. Right?
Right.
What's the square root of x to the 4th?
X2.
It would be x squared because it would be the square root of x squared times the square root of x squared. Square root of x squared is x. The square root of x squared is x. So that would be x times x, which is x. What would be the square root of 25y squared?
5y squared.
It'd be 5y or 5y squared?
5y. 5y. Because
5y
times
itself. Because we need 5 to multiply by itself to get 25, y to multiply by itself to get y squared.
Right, so 5y times itself.
5y times 5y is 25y
yeah.
squared.
Okay.
Okay?
That's it.